Okay, welcome to this week's Checking In With, presented by O'Neill. We are with Pierce Brown, missing in action, have not been at the Nationals due to an injury. So what exactly did you hurt, and when are you going to be back?
I broke these two bones in my hand right here, and I think it's been about 6 weeks. Tomorrow will be 6 weeks since I had surgery, so just trying to get back on the swing of things.
Yeah.
My goal is to get back my red butt, but I want to come back ready and fighting for podiums in top five. So whenever that is, whether it be red butt, Millville, or Southwick, I'll be back. But right now I'm just trying to get my feet wet and get back riding. I miss a lot of time and I just miss riding. So yeah, I'm out here trying to have some fun and get back into it.
So as a professional racer, like everyday grind has to get old a little bit. Is it sometimes, I hate to even ask, but is it sometimes nice to have a little break because of an injury?
Yeah, no, I mean, mid Supercross season, you're doing the same stuff every single week. Traveling, going to races, training, and it does get old. But time off kind of makes you, like, you know, like embrace that, you know? I missed it so much when I was off. I really had nothing to do besides just work out and therapy, so I was doing the same stuff, but I wasn't getting to ride and, like, have actual fun, so... yeah, it does get monotonous, but you do miss it when you're off for a while. So yeah, kind of hit a little reset when I was hurt, and yeah, hoping to stay fresh for the summer.
Okay, so you know, Caden Braswell is filling in for you. So you always talk to like a fill-in guy, and they're like, "Oh, it's so great to have this opportunity." Blah blah blah.
Yeah.
Bike's so great. What is it like being the injured guy that's being filled in for? Is it like, "Hey, man, go easy on my bike"? Or
it's tough. I've never had someone fill in for me before, so it's a little bittersweet watching like someone on your bike out on the race when you want to be out there. But you know, it's business. It's a team. They gotta put people out there. So yeah, I mean, it is what it is. But yeah, I did get a little bit jealous trying to, or just going to Paula, watching them out there, watching everybody out there, and
watching your mechanic signal him.
Yeah.
Right?
But no, it is what it is.
So how close have you been paying attention to the racing?
Well, I mean, for me, it's kind of hard to watch it like while it's live. I get a little bit bummed, but I'll try to watch it the day after and study and do all the like homework I can. Trying to make the bike better while being off the bike. Like I've been really close to Ollie the last couple weeks. Like just, you know, like throwing in my out ideas, like little stuff like that that I see and try to improve on. So in a way, it's kind of helped, like being able to step back and watch everybody else and see why their bike's so good, why they're riding so good, like what they're doing. So yeah, that part of it's cool, but I did miss it.
Yeah. What's been the most surprising thing for you to watch at the races, like results-wise or rider-wise, maybe?
Surprising. I don't really know. I mean, it's all been a toss-up. The 450 class has definitely been surprising. Almost want to get a 450 and start
racing
for
right?
Justin, you know?
Yeah.
Like, get some top five, maybe a podium, but no, I don't know. Everything's crazy this year. The 450 class is so deep right now. You saw Chance. He crushed it last week.
Yeah.
He went 11-3, but it just shows you can go, like, 11 first one and still have the speed to get a podium. Like, everybody is so good and the class is so deep, so it's really all about a start.
Yeah. Right on, buddy. Well, heal up. Be careful testing and getting back up to speed because we want to see you on the line.
Yeah, no, we'll be back soon.
Okay, thanks for the time.
Okay, thank you.
First time. Oh, there you go. Got it.